to be a very interesting Lifestyle Wednesday, as we have models in the studio for you tonight, and we're talking about modeling in Africa. We have Jamal Onange, who is a trainer under the Africa Models International. We also have Faith Kinyaka, who is a supervisor of the models that we are going to be showcasing tonight. So what we seek to understand today is, why should we put modeling as something that people are supposed to pursue? What are the challenges that are there? Some of the young models today are high school students. We also seek to know how they get to balance their modeling work and also their school work. So to start off today, Jamal, can you tell us who are you? You are, yes, from the details I have, is a trainer of and Africa International Models, but can you tell us more about Africa International?
Africa International actually is a modeling agency. Mm-hmm. That actually we focus on actually enhancing talent among the youth. Mm-hmm. And now the majorly we focus on all-round talent, but now today we have to talk about the models, because we actually see them grow. Mm-hmm. To the to that big industry, from local to the international level.
Okay. Yes. So Faith, I can see you are also Miss Kenya United Nations. Yeah. Can you first tell us what's your title? What's behind your title? What's the meaning of your title?
Okay, United Nations pageant is a pageant that focuses on charity. Mm-hmm. Like two weeks ago it happened in India, Jalandhar. Mm-hmm. And I won the title United Nations Ambassador. Mm-hmm. 2019. Mm-hmm. But I take more pride in carrying the Miss Kenya title.
Okay. Yeah. So we know that behind every title, every work, every talent and all that, there are certain characteristics that you look out for. What makes a good model? As you pick models under the Africa International Models, what are the characteristics that you look out for?
Actually, every talent, the first thing that goes with any talent is discipline. Mm-hmm. Once you have discipline, then you'll go places.
Okay.
Second, good training. Mm-hmm. Good training is it's actually something very, very important, because if you get good training, then who beat you? Mm-hmm. You have to be good. Mm-hmm. Another thing is that, okay, be outstanding. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to stand outstanding. So you have to be the best. Right. Mm-hmm. So when we are selecting our models, we look at your etiquette. Mm-hmm. Your behavior. Mm-hmm. Your discipline. That is what we focus on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Faith, you're a supervisor, but you're also a model. What would you say are some of the challenges that the modeling industry in Kenya go through, and how do you get to deal with them? Because I can see from the models that we have even very young girls.
Yeah.
You're a person who has been there before. What are some of the guidelines that you get to give to these young girls so that they get to the point that you are at right now?
The hardest challenges that models face in Kenya right now, mm-hmm. is the low payments. Mm-hmm. Like, you get models work for long hours and they get a very little payment. Mm-hmm. And this is because some models in Kenya have passed themselves, like they can work for free. Mm-hmm. Now the companies cannot get this serious model, mm-hmm. who they can pay. They'll be like, we can get models to work for free. Mm-hmm. Why pay you to get this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So what would you say now? How do we solve that challenge?
Every model should know their worth. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. For you, Jamal, being their trainer, and these are some of the things that you have, that you've talked about, discipline. Faith talking about the challenge of not being paid well. How do you make sure that your models in Africa International don't feel wasted, are appreciated? Because appreciating someone gives them the motivation to want to move forward.
Actually, let me talk about Africa. We give you that platform actually to stage yourself. Mm-hmm. a big platform. Mm-hmm. So you won't even go that low to be paid peanuts. Mm-hmm. You see, it depends with you as a model, what do you want? Mm-hmm. Do you want to be paid low? Do you want to be an international model? Mm-hmm. Then you yourself, you have to classify yourself. You see, yes, models go through a lot, mm-hmm. through a lot. Mm-hmm. But now, at some point, I will say that it's actually the models themselves who actually put themselves into this.
Okay.
You see, mm-hmm. like an example, somebody would want to you are going for a pageant to compete. And then you feel like, now I know the judge, one of the judges there, so mm-hmm. you try bribing the judges.
Okay.
You see, and that at the end of the day, it is not you representing yourself. Mm-hmm. Actually, you're representing yourself and the judge who's judged you. Mm-hmm. Because out there, if you mess, they'll be asked, who judged you? Mm-hmm. Who actually selected you? Mm-hmm. So even judges also have a problem. Mm-hmm. You receive bribes.
Okay.
You see? Mm-hmm. But now when it comes in African models, we train you to an extent that, okay, you have that class. You see, you won't even think of even bribing a judge because you believe in yourself, you trust in yourself, because the training that you got from the Africa is better than any other place.
Mm-hmm. Okay, there's a challenge of most some parents don't believe in talents. They believe that the only way for us to make it in life is go to class, get a good grade, and maybe become a doctor, become an engineer, and all that. How do you make sure that you bring in the parents on the table and convince them that investing in your child's talent is also something that is going to yield into beautiful things in the future? This is going to put your child in a certain platform, and they can also become independent just on the talent path. How do you get to do that?
Majorly, I will talk about all-round talent. Mm-hmm. Not all parents support talented students. Mm-hmm. But let me tell you one thing. When it comes to modeling, some parents think like, you're just going to waste your time and mm-hmm. all that. But now, the fashion industry needs models. Mm-hmm. And this is just like any other job, mm-hmm. you see. And actually, when you focus the government now, CBC is actually encouraging talent, mm-hmm. right? Now, we have parents who are not really... into talent. They believe it's books. Mm-hmm. But at some point you might find like this kid won't even make it, mm-hmm. because okay, maybe her understanding is very low, mm-hmm. or the kid is a slow learner.
Okay.
So once we engage them into that, because even you in school, you knew some students were good in theory,
yeah.
some were good in practical. Mm-hmm. So it applies in any other thing. Mm-hmm. That those kids who are good in books, right? But are those who can do good when it comes to talent. Mm-hmm. So as a parent, just help that kid to grow. Mm-hmm. Because now, who are the celebrities? They've gone through the same.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So Faith, when did you start modeling?
I started in 2016, mm-hmm. While in college, mm-hmm. NIBS College. Mm-hmm. There was audition for Mr. and Miss NIBS College pageant. Mm-hmm. And I never got the chance, mm-hmm. so I was taken as a curtain raiser. Mm-hmm. Again, 2017, I tried, and I got the chance to be a contestant. I appeared as top six. Then later on, I joined Afric Models. Mm-hmm. Through Jamal has been my trainer throughout. Mm-hmm. From 2018, I got the title Miss Essence, Kenya, mm-hmm. and now Miss United Nations Ambassador 2019.
Okay. Did you have any challenges at any point convincing your parents to support your modeling career?
Yeah, of course, because in the community that I come from, they mm-hmm. don't believe in this modeling thing. Mm-hmm. Most of them think like it's more of prostitution, mm-hmm. Something like that.
Which is a very sad thing.
Yeah, mm-hmm. sure.
So how did you now get to bring your parents on board?
No, I had to talk with my brothers, who explained later on to my dad. And mm-hmm. After they started seeing results, which are good, mm-hmm. they started supporting me.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Jamal, the models we have today participated in a model pageant in India. What is the experience when you get to take them out of the country and take them on an international platform? What would you say are some of the things that they get to learn from there that we don't so far have in this country?
Actually, when it comes to Kenya, they always focus on the runway, catwalk, and all that. But now when it comes to an international level, we have interview, you train them how to speak in public, you train them on how to catwalk and actually have that confidence. Mm-hmm. We train them on how to win a pageant. Because now in Kenya, he's like, okay, you hit the runway, you've been trained on how to walk, then that's your own. Right? Mm-hmm. But now we try to make them feel like international. Mm-hmm. Once they come back here, you can see the transformation in them. Mm-hmm. They're actually changed totally. Mm-hmm. You could see like the way they were carrying out themselves from before and now, it's totally different.
Okay.
Yeah.
So these are some of the modules are high school students. How do you make sure that even as they go through their modeling training, probably which I believe happens during the holidays, mm-hmm. they don't forget their books, they don't forget that they have assignments that they have to do, and time is gonna come, they'll have to go back to school, they have to be perfect in their talents and also perfect in their books, because I believe the two need each other to work well.
African models work closely with their parents. you see, and we actually give them a penalty.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't perform well, then you don't come to Africa.
Mm-hmm.
You have to perform better.
Mm-hmm.
You have to work hard and be good.
Mm-hmm.
So that once we see your results, because they always send us their results before they come to Africa for training.
Mm-hmm.
So we get to know their results. How good are you? How did you improve?
Mm-hmm.
So once you've improved, now we see, okay, now you mm-hmm. can come and I'll get trainings.
Okay.
But if you don't perform well, then you won't come.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What are some of your achievements, Faith, so far since you joined modeling? What would you say is something that you've been able to achieve that makes you feel proud of yourself and not ever regret joining that industry?
Number one, I've been able to visit so many countries,
mm-hmm.
East Africa and outside Africa,
mm-hmm.
through modeling
mm-hmm.
career. And also, I hit the runway for Swahili Fashion Week.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is something that you would advise a fellow young girl, a fellow young man to venture in.
Yes.
So to young girls and young boys watching us tonight, what is the message that you tell them? And send them a message on how they can pursue their talents, not only modeling. We have people who can sing, we have people who can draw, we have people who can act and all that.
In this entertainment industry, it's very competitive,
mm-hmm.
and they should always bear in mind that their strive to succeed is what set them separate. It's what separates them from the rest.
Mm-hmm.
They should always keep God first,
mm-hmm.
and they should not get worried when they don't get recognized.
Mm-hmm.
Instead, they should work hard to be worthy of that recognition.
Okay, well, thank you very much. I'm going to. I would like us to introduce the models that we have with us on studio tonight, because I'd like them to say their names, tell us what their titles are, because I have noticed that the titles of models under the Afrique International are very unique, something that I think we're not only talking about beauty.
Yes,
we can see there's beauty and the breadth.
Yeah.
So our dear models, please come this way and walk for us tonight. Just Victoria, just come this way. Yes. Okay, go that way and just stand next to Faith. Yes, this is our smallest and most beautiful. Hey, this girl is so beautiful. Mm-hmm. Welcome. Then the next one, we have Natalie. And then we have Lauren. Thank you very much, guys. As you can see, our viewers back at home, these are the models under the Afrique International models. And I want to start with you, Victoria. Victoria, how are you?
I'm fine.
Can you tell us what is your title?
My title is Little Miss Charity 2019.
And how old are you?
I'm 9.
This is really a challenge to parents, Jamal, that
sure.
We don't need to wait for our children to get to 18 years to give them such platforms. Why did you choose modeling?
Because when I was 6 years,
mm-hmm.
I loved to watch people who model,
mm-hmm.
people who wear long dresses,
mm-hmm.
and weddings.
Mm-hmm.
So my mom knew that I love modeling,
mm-hmm.
so she took me to Africa and saw her.
Oh, that is so nice. Joy?
Yeah.
How are you?
Fine.
Can you tell us what is your title? Victoria, add the microphone to Joy. Your title is Miss Teen Grand Prix. What is the meaning of that?
Mm-hmm.
For someone watching us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a chief. You're a chief.
Mm-hmm. Why modeling? Why not acting? And how do you find the modeling industry so far?
To me, modeling is just like, I liked it since childhood.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we have Natalie Lilan. How are you, Natalie?
Okay.
Your title reads Miss Teen Goodwill International 2019. Why did you get that title?
Because first of all, I worked really hard for this chance,
mm-hmm.
to India.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Is that the only reason that... Is it because you only worked hard for it? Because I can see it's goodwill, which means there must be something unique about it. I'll bring Jamal to tell us more about the crowns. And then we have Lorraine. Hi. How are you?
I'm fine.
Your title is Miss Teen Charity International. When did you start modeling?
I started modeling last year.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And so far, how do you find the modeling industry?
It's good.
Mm-hmm.
I can add the teams out there.
Mm-hmm.
Modeling really helps.
Mm-hmm.
Like now I've traveled to some countries.
Mm-hmm.
I've been to Rwanda,
mm-hmm.
Uganda.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm from India.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, Jamal, I want to bring you in on these. The titles that I can see here, we're used to seeing Miss Kenya, Miss World Kenya, and all those. But these titles are very unique.
Yes, sure.
What is the reason behind all of them?
First of all, you have to know that actually they were not competing with just a few countries.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, the whole world,
mm-hmm.
you see. And actually, they marked the best, as you can see,
mm-hmm.
them,
yes.
because of the trainings that they got.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if we talk about Goodwill International,
mm-hmm.
it's about the way you relate with people,
mm-hmm.
the way you interact with people at the bootcamp.
Mm-hmm.
So it gives you that title. And
mm-hmm.
actually getting that is very hard,
mm-hmm.
because they monitor you on whatever you're doing.
Okay.
And now when it comes to the Grand Prix,
mm-hmm.
Grand Prix actually it's a title
mm-hmm.
of a chief in France.
Mm-hmm.
So once they see the leadership in you, so they crown you that leadership.
Mm-hmm.
You see, now when charity, it explains itself.
Yes.
Yeah, it's all about charity.
Mm-hmm.
You see, so these models actually are competed with so many models out there.
Mm-hmm.
You see, now they match the best. And that's why they're here. They represented the whole Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, Faith, you supervise these girls. You walk them through different stages in their modeling career so far. What would you say makes these models unique to other models that we have? Because model agencies are very many.
Sure.
We have very many models. But what do you think makes these ones good models?
Their resolution to succeed,
mm-hmm.
and also their parents have been so supportive. First, we must get these models from their school.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I've gone to their schools,
mm-hmm.
we take them from their school when they know nothing about modeling.
Mm-hmm.
When they come to our national audition,
mm-hmm.
we select the best.
Mm-hmm.
Not actually the best, but if we see you have the potential, we give you that opportunity
mm-hmm.
to remain at our academy,
mm-hmm.
where Jamal trains them to be the best. And of course, their parents have been so supportive in terms of finances and everything that is required.
Mm-hmm.
They are first to help.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so Jamal,
yes,
these they went to India, they have these titles. What next for them?
Each and every model
mm-hmm.
must have a project,
mm-hmm.
and they can even tell you their projects.
Mm-hmm.
They do have projects in which they have to focus on that,
mm-hmm.
Because modeling is not just walking on the runway,
mm-hmm.
it's beauty with brains,
mm-hmm.
and then you have to help give back to the society.
Mm-hmm. When you talk about projects, maybe what are some of the activities that you get to give them?
Like, we have different projects that they have,
mm-hmm.
and now we support them, like if it's helping the vulnerable,
mm-hmm.
we go with them,
mm-hmm.
Give them that encouragement,
mm-hmm.
we talk to those kids and all that,
mm-hmm.
yeah? So we help them in so many ways, like actually preparing them
mm-hmm.
to the society.
Okay,
yeah.
So I would like to take these to our models now. Lauren, can you give the microphone to Victoria? Victoria, you're 9 years old, and I can say that I'm very proud of you. To be Little Miss Charity is not just easy, but how do you manage to balance school, to help your mom with the house chores, and to make sure that you're also doing well in your modeling career?
First, I focus mostly in school,
mm-hmm.
The trip starts while the school are closed.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I balance it.
Oh, okay. So, Natalie,
yeah.
How do you balance school and modeling? Because the message I would like us to pass today is that all things are possible, that parents should not feel like if they give their children the platform or the opportunity to focus on their talents, that they're not going to achieve anything in their curricular activities. So how do you manage to balance school and modeling?
Okay, during the holidays,
mm-hmm.
I make like a timetable or a schedule so that I can balance my studies,
mm-hmm.
my co-curricular activities, so that I don't forget the schoolwork,
mm-hmm.
and I also focus on my modeling and perfect it.
Okay, so Faith, we now, these girls, I'm sure now most of them, maybe there's someone who wants to do modeling fully, there's someone who wants to balance between the two. Besides modeling, what else do you have other activities that you do?
Personally?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I work with African Asa Production, mm-hmm. which is a film production company mm-hmm. that focuses on these young talents. Mm-hmm. And for us to get this talent, we go to their schools when they are in school. Mm-hmm. We get to audition the students. And when the school closes, we invite them for the national audition.
Okay.
Where they come showcase their talents.
Okay. For people watching us at home today, for parents, for young girls, for young boys who would like to venture into them into modeling, but they don't know, they don't have a mentor, because you see, I might have a dream, but I don't have someone to hold my head and tell me this is how you're supposed to go about it. What would you like to say to them today, Jamal?
I'll tell you, just believe in yourself. Mm-hmm. Then once you believe in yourself and have that passion, mm-hmm. then go for it. Mm-hmm. Because Africa Models is here for you. We're ready to receive you with good love and all that.
Okay. Yeah. Lorraine, I'd like you to talk to young girls like you. What advice would you give them? Someone, a young girl somewhere in whether in a town or anywhere in this county to talk about modeling.
First of all, I'll urge young girls, during the holidays, maybe you associate with something that will give you positive things to do. Don't do drugs and maybe premarital sex, mm-hmm. because you'll end up having early pregnancies. Mm-hmm. And maybe if you have that talent, you can come to Africa Nasaha, they'll help you. They have helped me really.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'll just ask the young girls out there to work for their talents. Maybe if you have the talent, come and
So Jamal, as we wind up, before I get more remarks from the models, if someone who wants to join Africa Nasar Productions, someone who wants to, maybe they can act, they can sing, because I understand that you don't only focus on modeling. Yeah. Maybe you can share your social media platforms and how they can reach you.
On Facebook, they can actually visit our Africa Nasar Production. Mm-hmm. For modeling, mm-hmm. you can visit Africa Models mm-hmm. International, that mm-hmm. is AFFRIK. Mm-hmm. And also, I would actually request them to actually come. We have our national auditions on 7th of December, mm-hmm. which will happen at Karen St. Mm-hmm. Elizabeth Girls. Mm-hmm. So you can come there, mm-hmm. and then you'll meet us there. Mm-hmm. Then we'll give you that platform to showcase your talent.
Okay. Yeah. Faith, your final remarks in this, your closing remarks, what would you want to say to parents, to students, to young people in campuses who want to pursue talents but they don't think they have the support system that is very, very, very backing them up?
To the parents, mm-hmm. I'll urge them to support these kids' talents, mm-hmm. because right now in Kenya, if you see a lot of people, mm-hmm. they're depending on their talents. Mm-hmm. Like, maybe you're working, and then your talent is your side hustle. Mm-hmm. So for this parent to support their kids, yeah.
Okay. I'd like Joy.
Yes.
Get the microphone, please. What message would you like to pass to parents who don't believe in talents?
Talent is a gift that God granted to everybody. Mm-hmm. We should not deny our children. Mm-hmm. Everybody has a chance. And we have to encourage our parents that it may take us far.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So Jamal, besides these ladies holding these titles, how do they now get to use them? Because I believe Lorraine is not just going to get the Miss Teen Charity International crown and just put on the crown. What does she get to do now for the society? Because I believe you're also training these people to come and now use their titles, to come and use their talents to help others in the society.
You know, once you have the crown and you have the sash, you become an ambassador of that mm-hmm. crown. Mm-hmm. So you stand out to actually talk to the youths mm-hmm. and give them whatever that you have that is very positive.
Okay.
You see, and then with them focusing on their projects, actually you yourself working like that, even in state house, they won't even allow you. But if she comes in with a sash, she's a royal, and people will just acknowledge her in that midst of the crowd. Now, the sash itself and the crown, it makes them stand out. You see,
okay.
And it gives them that platform. They can knock any door, and they'll be accepted.
Okay, it was really nice having you, young ladies, in studio tonight. And my hope for them is that they go and pass all that to other young ladies and young boys back at home. Make sure that that crown, your time, or your time does not just end with you just putting the crown and having to shine. Do something for the society. And I would like to say to Jamal and Faith, thank you very much for really guiding them. If every person in this country, I believe, would have a mentor or would have someone to guide them, it's easier to navigate than when you just have to do it all by yourself. And to parents and young people watching us tonight, you've had talents. It's something that can also pave way for your student, for your children. These are people who have not only visited Africa, but they've gone way beyond Africa. So it opens doors for your children. So let us not feel like investing in their talents is taking away maybe their education and all that. Let us find ways as parents, as siblings, to be very supportive of every talent that our children have. Thank you very much for having for joining us tonight on Y254 News. My name is Patricia Muriuki. Do have yourselves a very good night.